أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولو أنهم أقاموا التوراة والإنجيل وما أنزل إليهم من ربهم لأكلوا من فوقهم ومن تحت أرجلهم منهم أمة مقتصدة وكثير منهم ساء ما يعملون رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم قرآن ويكلي Today with the 66th ayah of Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ Had those people, had it been the case that those people established Tawrat and Injil, Allah's talking about the Jewish and the Christian communities of the past, when Tawrat and Injil was revealed to them, had they lived by those books, وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ رَبِّهِمْ And whatever else was revealed to them from their master, لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ They would have eaten from above them and from below them. Allah is saying, if you establish His book, life will be good, not only in Jannah, which is described in the previous ayah, in the 65th ayah, but life will be good here. You will eat from above and below. It's not like you're going to miss out on this world if you live by Allah's book. So cool. So many people think if they live by Allah's book, life will become hard. They'll miss out on things in life. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, if you only knew, I will open the doors of rizq, in the sky, the doors in the earth, and you will just consume, you will just live this luxurious life just based on what, just one thing you give me. You establish Allah's book, subhanAllah. Minhum ummatun muqtasida wa kathirun minhum sa'a ma ya'malun. Among them, meaning among the people of the book, there's a people that are fair. They're not super righteous. Muqtasida means they're okay, they're in the middle. You know, they're not top of the class, they're not failing, they're right in the middle. So Allah is saying that even if you can get to the middle, Allah would still give you. And then He says, وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ And so many among them, سَاءَ مَا يَعْمَلُونَ What terrible things they're up to. What horrible, horrible things they're up to. You look at some people, and you would never think these people believe in a book. You would never think they believe in revelation. And I'm not talking about Jews and Christians now, I'm even talking about Muslims. You know, have we become those people? Have I become that person? Have you become that person? Some things we do, you wouldn't even think this person believes in a book. This person believes in revelation, something higher from above, you know, some authority. And we do it. Sometimes we compromise the word of Allah because we say, man, we gotta eat. We gotta make a living. You gotta live a little. And this is the ayah. Allah says, if you only lived by my book, you would be living really, really well. You think this is living? I will open up so many things for you that you didn't even know existed. And not just Jannah, here too. لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ Today we argue, for example, that the Muslim Ummah is in such turmoil. We are, you know, resources have been stripped of us. We don't. We have corruption. We don't have even the most basic utilities available to us in a sustainable way. In so many places where Muslims, you know, where the earth is being stepped on by Muslim feet, subhanAllah. But Allah is saying, all you have to do is live by my book. That's all you have to do. And I'll take care of the rest. Your economy will come alive again. Everything will fall into place. The job will come. You know, the money will come. The food will come on the plate. Your children's education will be taken care of. لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ SubhanAllah. So this is something for you and I to reflect upon. For Allah giving us dunya is nothing. Because to Him it is nothing. For Allah, if we become people of Jannah, Allah will drop dunya on us like it's worthless. And really, until you and I keep running after this world and material things, and we only care about these things, so long as that happens, Allah will keep that even these things away from us. And even if you get them, they won't bring you any happiness. They will not give you any satisfaction in life. And the moment you and I decide that we have to become people of the Akhirah, we were put on this earth for something more. There's something more to our life than just being here. The moment we realize that and live by Allah's book, you're going to see just things that you used to think were a big deal will just drop in your lap. They will just come to you. And one after the other, subhanAllah. May Allah Azza wa Jalla open the doors of rizq for all of us, a rizq that brings us closer to Him and helps us build our homes in Jannah, not just in this dunya. Barakallahu li wa lakum, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.